Welcome to another episode, guys. You know, I get a lot of questions regarding stalled vehicles. My car recently stalled. I open the hood, I touch and tinker with a bunch of different things. For some reason, miraculously, the car turns on again. I have no idea why. I've changed my ignition coils, I've changed my fuel injectors. I keep on having the problem over and over again. It's intermittent. I don't have any check engine lights. And the one thing that a lot of people overlook is something very, very simple. In fact, it's the battery. Now, don't forget, if you have a bad connection at the battery, the car will shut off, without a doubt. And I'll come in for a close-up. This happens to be my vehicle, and I kind of caught something by accident, fortunately. But this is something pretty common, in that the battery cables are not secured on one of the battery posts. And if it loses a connection, or a very good connection with the battery, the car will shut off. You could be driving down the road 60 miles an hour, and if it loses a good connection, you're gonna shut off. And that becomes very, very dangerous, because maybe you can touch the brakes, if you're lucky, 2-3 times, because the power brakes, that's it, your brakes are gone. So if this is happening to your vehicle, check the battery, and to fix it is less than a dollar. You can get these battery post caps, which look like something like this. And these are less than a dollar. I picked these up from 99 cents at the auto parts store, and they're made out of lead, in fact. So this is going to correct the problem. Now, of course, here's the battery, and we have the negative and the positive terminal. Now, if we take a look at the negative terminal, this thing's really solid. It's not going anywhere. But take a look at the positive here. This is fully tightened, this bolt over here. Let me come in for a zoom. This bolt right here, it cannot be tightened anymore. I mean, I am maxed out. It can't go anymore. And if you take a look, the cable here, the connection, it's walking. I mean, look at this. I can lift it right off the battery post. And that becomes a very, very dangerous situation. So the cure for that is you can grab one of these battery posts. And these, again, slip right over the top terminal. And it corrects the problem. And now, as you can see, it's completely tight. This guy is not going anywhere. It doesn't get any easier than that, guys. So if you're having a similar problem, your car's stalling out, you open the hood, you tinker with different things, and for some reason it miraculously starts again, check the battery terminals, especially if your car is older. This is 17 years old, this car. So things wear out over time. And these terminals sometimes lose their grip. And as you can see earlier in the shot, in the video shot, that cable could not be tightened anymore. So that's where these caps are really a lifesaver. 99 cents, go to your local auto parts supplier. I'll list the name of this company in the description box below. Don't go crazy buying injectors, coil packs, and going nuts, because a lot of times that's not even the problem. If you're curious on how to test those things, I have a couple videos on my site at CarsNToys.net, and I show specifically how you can test injectors and how you can test coil packs. But, you know, just look at the basics. So if your car dies out, check the battery, because if you have a bad battery connection, nothing is going to happen. Zero, zilch. You need good battery connection. So it's very, very important that you check that. So we'll see you soon. I have a couple videos coming up very, very shortly. I know there's a lot of requests out there. I'm trying to get to all of them as fast and quickly as I can. But if you'd like to see more auto repair videos, just visit us on CarsNToys.net.